Happy Father's Day, and welcome to worship with St. Paul's United Methodist Church of Mendota Heights, Minnesota. I'm Amy Jo Burr, the pastor of St. Paul's, and I welcome you to join our congregation for worship today. Because it is Father's Day, let's begin our time of worship with a blessing prayer for our fathers. Will you please join me in a spirit of prayer? Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of each of our fathers, for the fathers of our birth, for the fathers of our adoption, for our foster fathers, and for all the fathers of the church who helped to parent us, provide an example for us, and to point the way towards you. Send your heavenly blessings upon all the fathers of our church. We pray that you would fill them with the wisdom, the strength, the energy, the patience, and the perseverance that would cause them to be able to parent well and in a way that is pleasing to you. While many of us are celebrating Father's Day on this day, O God, we know others are sad on this day as they grieve the loss of their fathers or remember a father who is geographically separated from them. For all those whose hearts are sad on this day, dear God, we pray that you would also pour out your compassion. And so, O God, send your blessings upon all of your people today, especially upon the fathers of the church. This we ask in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. This week is a special week in the life of St. Paul's, not only because it's Father's Day, but also because we have a mission trip who is leaving the church during this upcoming week. And so now as we begin our service of worship, let us pray together one of the great prayers of mission, the prayer of St. Teresa. Christ has no body now on earth but ours. No hands but ours, no feet but ours. Ours are the eyes through which Christ looks out with compassion upon the world. Ours are the feet with which he is to go about doing good. Ours are the hands with which he is to bless people now. Amen. Please join me in the singing of our opening hymn, Lord, You Have Come to the Lake Shore.
Side, I will seek of the seas.
Our first scripture reading is the Great Commission, Matthew 28, verses 19 through 20. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age.
Good morning. Today we are talking about mission work and being called by God to be missionaries. So a missionary is a person who goes out to share the word of God and through their faith provides services to people. So we can all be missionaries right here in our communities and anywhere in the world that we travel to. In fact, you might have heard that our church youth group just recently finished a huge mission project of serving 100,000 meals to the hungry. And a lot of that was done right here in our church. And now, later this week, 11 people from our church are going to be heading out on a trip across the country to do mission work. They're going on what's called a mission trip. Do you know what that is? It's kind of exactly how it sounds. It's when a group of people or a person goes on a trip with the main focus is to do mission work wherever they go. Now, there's thousands of different kinds of mission work, but it all comes down to helping people who need help. For some examples, I'm going to tell you what our group from the church will be doing on their mission trip. So we are starting in Minnesota, of course, and we're traveling all the way down to Greenwood, Mississippi by train. Greenwood, Mississippi is a medium to small town, and we'll be going to a humane society there and helping take care of all the animals. We will take them out to run and play outside so they get some exercise, and we will also help clean their kennels so they stay clean and healthy, and hopefully help them get adopted soon. Next, we're going to hop on another train and we'll be going to New Orleans, Louisiana. Now, New Orleans is a pretty big city. There, we'll be working on a large community service project. We could be helping fix up houses to make them livable again, or even help build new homes for people. Later that evening, we'll be helping make and serve dinner to all the people at a homeless shelter in their community. Again, after some train travels, our final stop for mission work is a very, very small town called Hope, Arkansas. Even though they are a small town, they have a lot of opportunities to help others. We will be partnering with a group called the Hope Connection, and they will be leading us in another community service project. Later that afternoon, we'll be volunteering with the Hope Community Garden, which is a very large garden that everything in it is edible. The idea that anyone who is hungry can come and take food from the garden to eat. There is a very famous John Wesley saying that goes, "Do all the good you can, by all the means you can, in all the ways you can, in all the places you can. At all the times you can, to all the people you can, as long as you ever can." And that is the goal for this mission trip. We aren't just going to one place to help. We are going to be shown how we can go to big cities, medium-sized towns, and even very, very small towns. And there is always places that we can serve and help.
Our second gospel reading is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 22, verses 34 through 40. Hearing that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, the Pharisees got together. One of them, an expert in the law, tested him with this question, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law?" Jesus replied, Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. The scripture readings today are two of the biblical greats, the Great Commission and the Great Commandment. The Great Commission encourages us to go and share the good news with the power of the Holy Spirit. And the Great Commandment teaches us to love God and our neighbor. Together, these two great scriptures inspire the missionary spirit in Christians around the world to go and share the good news of Jesus with all who need to hear that good news, doing good in every possible way as we share Christ. Now, it's a well-documented phenomenon that organizations often take on a bit of the personality and characteristics of their founders. In the case of the United Methodist Church, one of those characteristics which we inherited from our founder is from the missionary spirit of John Wesley. Now, Wesley was a Church of England pastor who was frustrated with the limited outreach of the Church of England at his time and in his location. He was especially frustrated with the selling of pews, which did not provide good hospitality for the poor. This seemed wrong to Wesley, and honestly, it probably seems wrong to many of us, too, who remember Christ reading, teaching, and embodying the words of Isaiah in Luke 4. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set free those who are oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And so, as John Wesley's frustration with the limited outreach of the Church of England grew, he made the bold step to begin preaching in the streets in order to reach more people. And as he did so, he made connections with many who were poor and some who were in recovery from addiction. And still to this day, in many of our congregations, you'll find a broad spectrum of socioeconomic classes in our church and the presence of recovery ministries in many locations. Now, Wesley organized the people who he reached into small groups for discipleship and for support and accountability in their spiritual journey. While John Wesley was beginning his ministry in England, he then traveled in 1736 and 1737 to the United States, landing at Cockspur Island in Georgia. The picture you're seeing is provided to us from Jan Marshall, who visited the historical site in Georgia on this location while she was traveling. Wesley began that ministry in the United States, once again, reaching out to all who he met. And eventually, after beginning ministry here in the United States, Wesley did return to England and ministry with the small groups developing there, keeping in touch and providing spiritual leadership with the Methodists in the United States, whose numbers were growing through small groups, through lay preachers, through camp meetings, and all of this under the clergy supervision of circuit riders who were clergy looking after a large number and riding from group to group of these locations of small groups. Now, the Church of England sent missionaries as the mission in the United States grew. However, after sending a number of missionaries to the United States, the Church of England was unable to keep up with the number of clergy who were needed as missionaries in this area. And because of this, the Methodist movement in the United States began to ordain its own clergy at the Christmas Conference on December 24, 1784, with the Reverend Thomas Coke presiding. This was the moment of founding a new denomination, not because of division or disagreement, but rather because of fast-spreading missionary spirit, which embodied the Great Commission and the Great Commandment. Now, the spirit continued in the new church, and the first missionary society of the Methodists was founded in 1819. And the United Methodist Church still continues in this missionary spirit today, with missionaries in approximately 60 countries, serving as pastors, evangelists, and church coordinators, teachers and educators, doctors, nurses, and other health workers, agriculturists, development specialists, community organizers, and peace builders. When my family moved to Texas and was looking for a new church, it was this spirit that attracted me to the local United Methodist Church. They were a congregation who was warmly welcoming of all people, and so I, of course, also felt welcomed there. And they were doing amazing work serving the poor. I experienced my call to ministry while serving as a volunteer in their homeless ministries. At St. Paul's, our congregation has been studying a book called Joining Jesus on His Mission, How to Be an Everyday Missionary, reminding us that there are opportunities to serve God in our life every day and in every location. These are all opportunities for us to take to heart the words of the Great Commission and the words of the Great Commandment, sharing the good news, teaching people to do everything that God has instructed, and doing good in every possible way as we love God and neighbor. I encourage all of us to allow the Great Commission and Great Commandment to speak to our hearts and to move us so that we share Christ and do good, loving God and neighbor in all that we do every day. Now, in addition to serving right where we are every day, St. Paul's also has a mission trip who will be traveling to serve in mission beginning on Saturday of this week. And so I encourage you all to also keep our traveling missionaries in your prayer as they go to serve God in several different locations throughout the United States. Perhaps you have also served on a mission trip at some time in your past and have known the blessing both of serving God and the good that was done as you showed love of neighbor, but also of the way your own heart and spiritual growth happened because of that commitment to the Great Commission and the Great Commandment. May God pour out God's richest blessings on our congregation, that we might continue to be filled with a missionary spirit and to reach out through both the fulfillment of the Great Commission and the fulfillment of the Great Commandment. Amen.
As a fire is meant for burning with a bright and warming flame, so the church is meant for mission. giving glory to God's name, not to preach our creeds or customs, but to build a bridge of care. We join hands across the nation, finding neighbors everywhere. We are learners, we are teachers, we are pilgrims on the way. We are seekers, we are givers, we are vessels made of clay. By our gentle, loving actions, we would show that Christ is light. In a humble, listening spirit, we would live to God's delight. As a green bud in the springtime is a sign of life renewed, so we be signs of oneness, Midas peoples many hued. As a rainbow lights the heavens when a storm is past and gone, may our lives reflect the radiance of God's new and glorious moon.
Please join me as we pray together our community prayer. Our prayer is simple. May we choose love, Lord. May we choose love when faced with retaliation, love when tempted by deception, love when addressing poverty, love when speaking to our neighbors, love when lured by bad choices, love when electing leaders. In all the things we do, in all the words we say, and in all the places we go, may we always choose love. Amen. Let us continue in prayer, praying together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our worship service today has focused on mission. And so as we come to the time in the service when we present our gifts and offerings to God, I think it's an important time for us to remember that while most of the financial gifts given to St. Paul's United Methodist Church stay right here in Mendota Heights, some of them are also shared through apportioned giving in order to support our portion of giving to mission around the world. I always enjoy seeing snapshots of what some of our missionaries are doing, so I want to share just a few quick snapshots with you today. The first is of Dr. Marie-Claire Manifundu, who coordinates the church's maternal and child health program in Eastern Congo. In the photo that you're seeing right now, Dr. Manifundu is in one of the nutrition and food ministries, supporting good health and nutritious eating in her area. The Yambasu Agricultural Initiative stresses the importance of reinvestment of profits for larger yield and crop strength in the coming years, therefore building sustainability in agricultural initiatives in its area. And the photo you're seeing here is farmers in Nigeria's Northeast Conference bagging rice after a bumper harvest of dry season rice farming. In order to commemorate World Water Day, Global Ministries celebrates with United Methodists in Cote d'Ivoire, who built 4 water towers with pump and wash stations, bringing clean, potable water to rural areas. And finally, I want to end with a picture from the United Methodist Committee on Relief, who provide disaster relief in the face of natural disasters like hurricanes or floods, or human-created crises such as war. In this photo, Natalia, a Ukrainian refugee, pauses as she sorts clothes at the Church World Service and UMCOR Balti Center in Moldova. She and her family have found a warm home in this Moldovan community. Let's bless all of the offerings that are now being received in support of the ministries of St. Paul's and each of the ministries that you have just seen. Please pray together with me a prayer of thanksgiving. Almighty God, giver of every good and perfect gift, teach us to offer to you all that we have and all that we are, so that we may praise you not with our lips only, but with our whole lives, turning the duties, the sorrows, and the joys of all our days into a living sacrifice to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Refreshed by living waters, renewed by living bread, may we, your sons and daughters, by your own hand be led. Accept the gifts we offer, receive the lives we owe, unite us in your service, may seeds of justice grow. Amen.
Please join me as we sing our final hymn, We Are Called. Let us go with the blessing of God. May the blessing of God, fountain of living water, flow within us as a river of life. May we drink deep of her wisdom. May we never thirst again. May we go through life refreshing many as a sign of healing for all through the one who is life eternal. Amen.